The Edmonton Oilers end their season opening six-game homestand with a convincing 6-3 victory over the Pittsburgh Penguins. Tony Brar here alongside former Edmonton Oilers netminder and analyst Ben Scrivens. And Ben, obviously all of oil country held their collective breath when Connor McDavid went down in the second period with an injury. Good news, he came back. Even better news for the team, they rallied behind that and scored five unanswered goals to erase a 3-1 deficit.
Yeah, undoubtedly. There's a collective pucker in Oilers Nation, hoping that he was going to be okay. I mean, it looks serious. I mean, anytime you have a back injury, I mean, that's such a predominant nerve-located spot. So, you know, everybody was concerned. And fortunately, he came back. It seems he's pretty unscathed. But exactly to your point, I mean, that was what kick-started. It was that power play that Tyson Barrie scored. A bit of a pinball goal got them to within a goal. And from there, Evander Kane, Nuge, Draisaitl just kind of kept the heat on and the intensity going for the remainder of the period.
And it was those three players registering multi-point nights, that, of course, being Leon Draisaitl, who said, hey, don't worry, if my captain hurts his back, I'll put the team on my back, a goal and two assists as he now leads the Oilers in scoring with 11 points. Nugent Hopkins and Kane also picking up a goal and an assist each. But when you look at that second period, the Oilers set a franchise record with 26 shots in a single period. When you look at that, how much of an indication is it to see what can truly happen with this Oilers club when all systems are firing?
I mean, you have to look at the reality of this game, and you are playing an undefeated in regulation Pittsburgh Penguins team. They have their core intact still. They've got a returning netminder who's put up phenomenal numbers the last few years in Tristan Jarry, who's playing in his quote-unquote hometown where he played junior hockey. So he's obviously elevated to be back in this rink. You know, those are tough opponents to play against, and they're playing a greasy road game. They're trying to just grind one out, and they know how to do those. Win those types of games pretty effectively. So for the Oilers to be as dominant as they were in that second period really shows you where the ceiling is, where the expectation is for this team.
I know a lot of the top guys are going to garner all the attention, and rightfully so, but a guy that can't be overlooked is Ryan McLeod. I mean, he chips in with another goal, his third of the season already, and that line continues to build and gain momentum and tilt the ice in the Oilers' favor. That has to bode well for the Oilers as they go up against these top teams like the Pittsburgh, like the Carolinas, and like the St. Louis Blues.
Yeah, and you heard Coach Woodcroft singing the praises of this line and McLeod specifically, the work ethic that he brings to practice, so that when he finds himself in opportunities in the slot, he's feeling automatic in those. And he's really, his coaching staff is really crediting the hard work that he brings to the rink day in and day out for capitalizing on those opportunities. And to his credit, three goals in six games, I mean, that's a blistering pace, especially for a guy who's not getting power play time, right? You look at these top point producers around the league, and they're getting a decent amount, a not insignificant percentage of their points off of the power play. When you have a guy that's contributing and scoring at a rate that's helping the team and helping the team ice good teams like the Pittsburgh Penguins away, those are important goals. So all the credit goes to that line, not just McLeod, but Ryan and Fogle as well.
Ryan McLeod put the final stamp on this one, putting five unanswered goals on the board for the Edmonton Oilers as they rally for their third win of the season. But they had to be kept within striking distance, and goaltender Jack Campbell did exactly that.
Yeah, I mean, this is a 6-3 game, right? We're not going to look at the box score and say this was a goaltending battle, but to a degree, it kind of was. I mean, Tristan Jarry played phenomenal in that second period. He airmailed that pass in the first to earn himself an assist and help get his team a two-goal advantage early in the game. But when you look at Jack Campbell made some really timely saves, some quality saves. He didn't get out of position where he had to force himself to make any sprawling sort of acrobatic saves. But to me, that's the type of goaltending that you want, because it's repeatable, right? When you have Jack Campbell playing in this way where he's just giving the team a chance, he's weathering storms. It's a la Grant Fuhr back in the 80s, right? Where you didn't need him to steal a game. He wasn't expected to get a shutout every night. But you have to give the team a chance. And right now, tonight especially, Jack Campbell gave the team a chance last game against St. Louis, even though they didn't win, gives the team a chance. You know, he's steadily improved from the start of the year. So you're hoping that he's really starting to feel good about himself, getting comfortable with this new team, the new systems, the new environment. And you really hope that this is, you know, a good start for him.
The Oilers pick up their third win of the 22-23 NHL season. Jack Campbell picks up his third win in the blue and orange. And speaking of orange, you'll notice I'm wearing an orange boutonniere here today for covering this tonight's hockey game. And that is symbolic of Diwali. Obviously, it's the Festival of Lights, so happy Diwali to everyone celebrating here tonight, including my beautiful family. And hey, it's known as the Festival of Lights, and the Oilers lit the lamp six times en route to their third victory of the season. Ben, always appreciate your time.